Welcome everyone, it is Andrew from MAO Magic. Apple every year releases new cases for their latest phones. And this year we have an entirely new phone, the iPhone X. To go with that new phone, we have the old standbys, the silicone case, the leather case, but now we have a new one, which is the leather Folio. So we are going to walk through all of the cases one by one, check them out, see what's changed compared to the other cases, what their special features are, and give our recommendation on which case may be best for you. Now, it is worth noting all of these cases come in a whole variety of different colors. To keep things fairly consistent, we chose the blue color in all three cases to test out. First, we have the leather case. This is one of my favorite cases and one that I've used on my phone for many years. It ages very well over time and has a really nice soft leather finish. It has metal hardware. You can see the elongated lock button on the new iPhone X, and it still has the power button or the volume buttons on the other side and an opening cutout for the mute switch. On the inside, it has a microfiber lining as well as the iPhone logo. The microfiber just goes along the back and it does not go up the sides, whereas the silicone case, it does go up the sides, but it is still leather, so you're not going to have any issues with anything hurting your phone. And of course, it has the larger camera cutout along the back. Moving on to the second case that Apple released, which is the silicone case. The leather case is more expensive and more fancy, I'd almost say. The silicone case is more of a workhorse. It's going to be more rugged, more durable, and more susceptible to pretty much anything. It's going to be a lot more waterproof than the leather option as well. It still has that microfiber lining, but like I mentioned, it does go all the way up the sides compared to on the leather version. Instead of the metal hardware on the sides, it just has silicone ones, so nothing really fancy to see there. It has the same hardware buttons on as the other cases, where you have the volume rocker on one side, the power button on the other, and then the cutout for the mute switch there on the side. So that is still very easily accessible because all these cases are fairly thin. All of Apple's cases also have that open up bottom, which many people don't like, so that really is up to you on if that's a problem or not. Now the newest case, the one that everyone really wants to know about, that is the leather Folio. This is a wallet style case that just easily opens and closes. And what's nice is you can hold your cards in it, but you can still use features like wireless charging, because if you had the cards on the back, it would definitely interfere with the wireless charging and hurt your credit cards. On that inside pocket, you have a slot easily able to hold a few different credit cards and another pocket underneath. It is very easy to open up and has a few tricks up its sleeve as far as how that opening up works. There is a few instructions, and I don't really know if you can call these instructions, but they're just making it important to note that the credit cards must go into the pocket. Now, the right half of this literally feels like the leather case. It just happens to be attached to this Folio instead of being on its own. On the bottom left-hand corner of that left side, there actually is a little magnet, and that's what you have to keep your cards away from. So you have to make sure the cards go into this little pocket here between those two little sew spots, or they could be damaged from that magnet. You don't want to just carry around a couple cards and have them deactivated because you got them too close to the magnet. So you can put a few cards in there as well as some cash or business cards or something else underneath on that bottom flap. So why is that magnet there? Well, it's actually used to wake and sleep your phone. So when you open up the iPhone X Folio, your iPhone X will wake and it'll try to unlock using Face ID. And then when you close it, it'll automatically lock your phone. So you don't have to worry about hitting the power button. You literally just close the Folio and it'll automatically lock for you. It's actually very handy and it works very similar to the smart cases on the iPads. There's just that magnet in the case and the little sensor on the bottom right-hand corner of the iPhone X. As you probably know by now, one of the flagship features of the iPhone X and the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus is wireless charging. And all of these three cases, the leather, the silicone, and the 10, all will work with wireless chargers. So you don't have to worry about that compatibility. Of course, if you happen to have the flap folded back on the iPhone X, it's not going to be the case. So just make sure the iPhone Folio is closed before you set down on there and you'll have no issues. Most wireless chargers have little status symbols to let you know the status of the charging anyway. So which case do you need? Well, if you're an outdoorsy person, you're running around a lot, you need that more rugged nature, go for the silicone case. If you want something that looks a little bit nicer, a nice medium solution is that leather one, and it stands up very well over time. And if you want to be able to hold your cards with you and the latest and newest, definitely check out the Folio. It's well built, works really well, and is the only case right now out on the market that can open and close your phone automatically. All of these cases are currently available from Apple right now. You can follow the link below in the description to find them for yourself. Let us know what you think of these cases and which one is your favorite down below in the comments. Otherwise, subscribe, and until next time, it's Andrew for MAO Magic.